I think unintentionally, we have scared Jaina Lee Ortiz.
I think so.
Out of her mind. Station 19, big new Shondaland show. And here's the thing, you're having really good luck. And this is the difficult question. You did Rosewood with Morris Chestnut. Mm-hmm. Jason George is in this. Compare the handsomeness of these two men. Wow.
It's too hot to handle. Yeah. You have Boris Kojo.
Right. Oh, my gosh.
I mean, Dermot Mulroney. The list goes on.
So do you just pause? Because this happens to me. It's happening right now. I'll be sitting and talking to somebody and be like, oh, my gosh. does that happen to you when you're going back and forth with
no.
these fellas?
You get lost in their dreamy
eyes.
You
get lost in their dreamy
eyes? No, they get lost in my dreamy
eyes.
Yeah. All right, very good.
There you go, Jim.
but here's the thing that people don't appreciate. We did the story about Damon Wayans earlier. I mean, this is fun, exciting story. You know, mm-hmm. another big show for you. Mm-hmm. But these are long hours.
Long hours. And what we have to wear is another story. You know, we wear the full firefighter turnout gear. Yeah. And that's like 40, 50 pounds. Wow. We're wearing it all day. We're sweating all day.
Wow.
So there is the physical element that also adds on to the 13 to 16 hour days. But you know, when you're working in Shondaland, you are every morning is Christmas morning.
Mm. Right.
You know, you're living the dream. It's a great place to be in. People are passionate and hungry to work.
Well, let's talk about the distinction, because you're not the first person who said that, and you've mm-hmm. worked on other shows for other production companies. It's not to besmirch them. How is this different?
It's true. It's very true. You know, Shonda Rhimes has created an environment mm-hmm. where, you know, women have an opportunity to succeed. You know, it's inclusive, it's diverse, and you feel that energy on set, behind and in front of the camera. So it's incredible.
There we go. All right, here we go. Now you're the daughter of the former captain.
Yes.
And have you taken over?
I think so. I mean, in my real life, it's almost similar, because my dad is a former homicide detective in the Bronx. And so just to carry that legacy, there's a huge responsibility. I have to sort of, you know, live up to the name. But yeah, it's
So in real life, when he would come home, would you see the badge on his like belt buckle, or where do they?
I would see the gun on the table, but no. And every time a gun, no. That's
but the
true.
Stories your dad must
the
have.
The stories that he has are intense.
Wow. And yeah.
Jaina, hard at work here. Take a look. Watch.
This is the floor. Jack contained the explosion by closing these fire doors. The fire's probably burned itself out by now.
Oh, we're about to get swallowed up by a backdraft.
Either way, we gotta get in there.
Do we though? Have to get in there? Maybe it's safer if we wait for backup. Vic went to get more help.
It's hot. Trying the handle.
It's probably the pressure pulling it shut. Or it's warped. Probably melted. If it is hot enough in there to warp this door, maybe we should think about what it is we're doing here. A backdraft could kill us instantly. We don't even know if this building is still structurally sound.
Well, then go. If you don't want to be here, just go.
Yikes.
Ooh. Wow.
Wow. That's, I mean, do you feel like when they say cut, are you like, phew?
Well, we're in a pool of sweat.
Right.
So we just want to take off everything. Mm-hmm. Yes. When they call cut, it's like, yes, thank God, finally.
Wow. Well,
but you know what? Compared to the real life heroes, we shouldn't be complaining.
Sure,
you know what I mean? They walk into any situation and will risk their lives to save someone else's. So it's, you know.
TGIT tonight at 9 on ABC. Nice to see you.
Yay,
thanks
thank
so much.
You.
Thank you. Thank you.